Hey guys, in this video I want to talk about specific electrophilic alpha substitutions called alpha halogenations. So it turns out that alpha halogenation can proceed through an acid catalyzed and a base catalyzed mechanism. I'm going to show you both, but it's important to note they actually yield different products because of what the intermediates look like, okay? So the acid catalyzed mechanism is always going to yield mono halogenation, okay? Let me show you what this mechanism looks like. So, for an acid catalyzed mechanism, this is going to proceed through the enol tautomer, okay? So we're going to be trying to make the enol tautomer. The way it works is, let's say you're using just H3O+, okay? And you protonate, okay? What you're going to wind up getting is something that looks like this. Okay, I'll just draw it like this. Okay, double bond. Oops, that's terrible. So another one. There we go. Okay. And then we can make the enol. The enol would be with the conjugate base, right? So you take off the alpha carbon or the alpha proton with water, my conjugate. I would do this, this, and this. So then I get my enol tautomer. Cool? Okay, so this enol is now a pretty good nucleophile. So I can use it to attack my diatomic halogen in a similar way, not really the same way, but similar to another nucleophile, okay? So you would go ahead, grab one of the X's, kick off one of the X's, and what you wind up getting is a molecule that looks like this, OH with now a new X here, okay? Oh, also, I'm sorry, the mechanism would do this. You would also bring down the electrons to reform the double bond. So what you would get is something like this, okay? So that would be kind of the intermediate, okay? Eventually, this gets deprotonated using water, and you get back to your keto form, okay? So that's what we call our alpha halogenation. Notice that we add an X to the alpha position, but we only add one time. Now you might be wondering, Johnny, why would you only add once? Why does it not add again? Well, it turns out that having the X there to pull electrons away from the alpha carbon is going to make it less likely to make an enol next time, because the enol is going to require a positive charge on that carbon, and not on that carbon, but on those carbons. And by pulling away extra electrons, you make it less likely to form an enol. So it only reacts once. Cool so far? Awesome. Now this is in contrast to the base catalyzed mechanism, okay? So in the base catalyzed mechanism, you may yield polyhalogenation, okay? And the reason is you're basically gonna yield as much halogenation as you have alpha protons. The reason being, guys, that in a base catalyzed mechanism, the X's being there is just going to make it more reactive the second time. Let me show you. So in a base catalyzed mechanism, imagine that I'm using OH negative and that I'm just forming an enolate right away. And that enolate looks like this. Negative charge. Okay? Well, that negative charge can react with X2. Do this, do that, go here, go there, and give me my halogen, okay? But now when it sees that second equivalent of base, guess what's gonna happen? Now we have a dipole pulling away, so it's gonna be easier to put a negative charge there because the negative charge is gonna be stabilized by the halogen. Therefore, we're gonna replace every single halogen that was, or every single hydrogen that was there. We'll replace all of those alpha hydrogens with X's, and we're going to get poly substitution. Okay? Now, the only reason that I put may yield, not will yield, is because obviously you need multiple alpha protons in order for it to get poly halogenated. Okay? If you only have one, then you're only going to substitute once. But you can basically continue to react, continue to keep reacting until you're out of alpha protons. Interesting, right? Cool, guys. So in the next video, I want to show you an application of alpha halogenation called the haloform reaction.